Everyone, Genesis Writer here with another Genesis Tips and Tricks video. Today I'll be looking at a perfection I got while playing Big Team Battle in Halo 2 Anniversary on the map Stonetown. This is a remake of Halo 2 Classic's Zanzibar and Halo 3's Last Resort. And during this gameplay, I'm going to teach you how to grab rockets and control them effectively while essentially getting infinite ammo for them throughout the game. And I'm going to be showing you how to control the active camouflage power-up throughout most of the game, timing it so that you can remain invisible for the majority of your gameplay. So, off the start here, I'm going to be showing you how to get rockets very quickly off the start when you spawn inside the base. You want to go up the center of this stairway, not on the side as you see me doing here. You want to go up the center of your stairway and then crouch jump up into this ledge. Now, the reason why I'm saying not to go on the side as you see me doing here is because I fail at the jump. Oftentimes, because your teammates will all rush up the stairway behind you, they'll push you out of the way as you're going up that stairway, and you won't be able to make that jump. That wasn't the case there. That was just a mistake on my part. Now, I want you to see just how far I am ahead of my teammate who decided to go up the stairway behind me to get rockets and took the long way around. Look how far I am ahead of him right now. Now, think if I had made that jump on the first try, just how far I would be ahead of him then. Keep that in mind when going for the rockets, which spawn up here. This is the fastest way to get two rockets on Stonetown that I know of. Watch your radar and make sure that no vehicles push over here. And I want to explain briefly for a minute why this is a little bit precarious, this very strong push-up on Camo Tower. This strategy that I'm using right now, this little jump and push up this ramp immediately, works except for one small detail that doesn't really come up much in this film and I want to point out so that you know it when you're applying it to your gameplay. The enemy sniper has a full vantage point of where you are, and if they're watching Camo Tower, which most of them are not and are going to be doing what this guy's doing and going to be watching Froman, because Froman, or Camp Froman, this little base over here, is where the red sniper rifle spawns on the ground here. Just keep in mind that that sniper can see you from that window, and you should be keeping an eye on him, that area, out of the corner of your eye. Okay, just keep that in mind. Right here is a really great vantage point, because you can see who's going to be pushing you on Camo Tower, and you can see if this player is going to make this jump up this little rock right here, and they're going to make the jump up here. You can just basically see what you have to work with. Right here, luckily enough, I only meet one player, so I'm able to get a really good rocket off of on him for the first strike. Eventually I'm going to back up and jump through this little window. That's a really nifty jump you need to make. When you grab camo, it's going to be 1 minute and 15 seconds till the next camo respawns, and you have about 45 seconds of active camouflage. Now, instead of wasting ammo, I'm just going to punch this little red button, but instead of going over on the bridge, I'm going to jump using the turbine blades. I'm going to get a really solid vantage point. Right now, I know because we just spawned on this base side, I know that generally speaking, we're still going to be over here and the enemy team is going to be over there. So my job right now, being up on the vantage point, is to see who has pushed over and made it to our side. Seeing this one guy down here, I'm going to clean him up, and I see another guy off to the left right here also pushing over. My goal is to keep them spawning on the beach so that they don't spawn in the base. The reason being is that the beach doesn't have very many power weapon spawns, except for that sniper, as you see this guy now has. If you spawn in the base, you can immediately rush out and get a top height advantage, possibly grabbing rockets, dropping down, and you're going to be able to get the sword right here, which someone has dropped, and then go over to Camo Tower. In other words, the base is the better spawn on this map by far, so we want to keep them spawning on the beach. I get a long-range rocket on this guy. Don't quite reload my rockets as I see this free kill kind of hanging out. Then I spot this one-shot player off to the side and kill him for the triple kill, getting the Guardian Angel. Notice this guy sneaking up on me and shoot him for the overkill. Unfortunately enough, my teammate does end up cleaning up a possible kill-tacular over here. But I would like to point out here that there's no way I would have survived the situation I just did, because I was very, very tunnel-visioned. Once I zoomed in on this player, there's no way I could see my radar in the bottom left-hand corner. In Halo Combat Evolved, you can see a radar, and in Halo 4, if you're using a specific armor ability perk, you can also see your radar in the bottom left, but in any other game, you can't when you're zooming. So, it was very lucky that my teammate Yoel the Owl, who I was playing with, communicating with, distracted this player. Otherwise, I likely would have died in this situation. There's no telling that this film probably wouldn't have been able to be uploaded by me, because it wouldn't have had the spree that it did and the perfection that it did. So Yul cleans up that possible kill tacular here, and I want to briefly go over here. I hear that guy is a sniper, so I'm just going to kind of back down, but I want to go over briefly here my goal in this film and the strategy I use to get perfections and get long sprees on this map. The rocket ammunition spawns right here, and when you have zero rockets in reserve, in other words, when that counter on the top right of your screen that you're seeing right now reads zero, you will pick up the maximum amount of rockets from this canister, which is four, okay? If you have any more or higher than zero rockets remaining in reserve, you will not collect the full amount of rockets that you can. Notice how I'm not going after these players, because my goal is to use the camo I just grabbed to drop down and stealthily drop down, grab camo, and then stealthily make my way back. And sometimes the situation doesn't work out in that way, but in this case, I'm going to try to eventually make my way back. Unfortunately, I choke in the jump here, but I'm able to find a player behind me. There's no need to really rush these kills, and so my camo has just run out. I'm going to jump up here. I see that they've spawned on camo tower side, so I'm going to really try to stay alive by just dropping down here. It's really lucky that I actually shot the fusion coils. You really want to do that, because otherwise someone would be able to shoot me and I would die here. So I'm going to maybe see if I can lock on this ghost, but I'm not able to. I jump up and see an AFK player across the map. AFK stands for away from keyboard. It's an abbreviation. I don't understand why players don't use away AFC, away from controller, but I suppose that is just a verbal technicality. Get the vehicle destroy assist here, and I'm just patiently waiting this out. This little corner right here, as long as your team is spawning inside the base or is above you, as I can see my teammate is right now, this little corner right here is really underrated. You can stay alive for quite some time, and I'm going to make this little nifty jump up to top center. You want to be using this jump constantly to get back to camo tower, as you see me doing here, watching out for people in the window. I actually don't check the window enough, as you probably have already noticed during this gameplay. I just don't check the window enough. There's a lot of people who will stay on the window like this, and it's just important to keep that in mind as I make my way back to camo tower here. When your camo has faded, you have about 30 seconds until the next camo. So again, I'm going to pick up a camo. A minute 50 seconds from now, the next camo is going to come up. I have about 45 seconds of active camouflage, with 5 seconds after that of semi-mirage camo as it fades, then 30 seconds after that until the next camo comes up, a total of a minute and 15 seconds. Now, I'm not dropping for kills like this. I'm certainly not going to drop if this guy drops, but he doesn't. He stays out really kind of, unfortunately, he stays out in the other fusion coils, and I'm able to eventually register my shots here against this player. I wasn't aiming quite high enough there. I get the double kill, and I do a really good job on this guy getting away here and throwing a deterrent grenade and really distract him using my teammate. This is a really worth pointing out from this player's perspective, because this player sees a very different picture painted out in front of him as this happens. So I want to show you here. As I get the double kill here, this guy kind of engages me, and then he fades out behind this bridge, so he's not able to see me as I drop down. That's why you never want to drop this bridge using this red button. You can always just cross this little gap using a jump. There's no need to drop this bridge. And so what he sees when he comes back around the corner is this guy on the ground, okay? And he thinks this is me. This is not me. I'm actually just over here. So that's one way you can use to fake out players using the camo. So the reason why I'm circling all the way around like this is because this guy clearly spawned inside the base, and so I think that more players may spawn inside the base. I want to make sure that I'm not on that side when I'm going for rockets. Now, one thing I was very surprised at when I jumped across here is that I incurred fire from this same person who somehow sees me again. So I was really curious and went back in theater mode, and I found out something that's really, really useful. You do not want to jump when you're going across this, like this, okay? You do not want to jump off of this little ledge. The reason why is because when you do jump, you encounter this brightly lit surface right here of this rock. And you can see that when I'm over this brightly lit surface, I shimmer way more. And you can easily see through the camo and see that someone is in camo. But when someone is in the darker areas of the map, as you can see right here, it's much harder to see me right here than if I was crossing over the lighter area. So don't jump. Don't jump off this ledge, at least. Stay in the shadows of the map. That makes your camo that much more effective. So for example, you can see where the shadows kind of exist right here and how they don't exist over here. It's very important to realize that when you're using active camouflage. Once again, I have 4 rockets in reserve in the top right. Pick the camo up and I get 4 rockets. I believe you can hold a maximum total of 6 rockets, 4 in reserve, 2 in your clip. So you can have 2 in your clip and 0 in reserve and get 4 rockets from the ammo. Now I would like to point out here, I should not have tried to long-range engage these people who were top rocket spawn with my BR. There was no need to do that. I needed to use my camo to try to get back to top center. Unfortunately, these people would have also sensed me on my radar, and this guy's on the turret. The turret will absolutely shred you in Halo 2 Anniversary. It is a very fast-killing weapon. In my opinion, a weapon that's a little too fast-killing. I would like to point out here, as I switch to my teammate down, Bubfield, who's over here, calls out this elite is coming around the corner. He's able to get a few shots in on this elite as this elite comes around the corner and is going to engage me here. So I'm going to switch back to my perspective as I long-range rocket this guy on the turret. No need to lock on the guy on the turret. You can to lock on to vehicles and turrets in Halo 2 Anniversary. You simply hold down the fire button while zooming, or while not zooming, and you will see it lock on. Now, I would like to point out a very smart movement decision I make right here. And a lot of sort of beginner players wouldn't know to do this. You can see that on the right-hand side, I have all my teammates kind of spawning off to the right, or in general, they're in that area. I can see all those blue arrows. What that means is that the enemy players are most likely going to be on the opposite side, or where my teammates are not, which is in this base. The base gets a lot of safe spawns, and occasionally, as you saw earlier in the film, the people will spawn over here near rocks beside the camo tower. So what I'd like to point out here is that I'm going to run to the right here. I'm going to strong side, maneuver coined after the MLG pro player strong side. You kind of angle your aiming reticle downward so that your head is harder to hit from behind. It's harder to headshot you, essentially. It doesn't affect people when sniping you, but your head is harder to hit. And that's very useful. Now, I would like to point out a little glitch here that happens. You can see this grenade indicator pop up, and yet there's no explosion. And I want to point out this very quickly to you, backing up twice in the film, so you can see what happens to this grenade. This is a common glitch in Halo 2 Anniversary, where grenades will remain alive but freeze and not blow up in midair. And while you can see them until they disappear, they remain as active grenade indicators on your HUD, which is why I kind of pause there for a second. Now you're going to hear me pick up the next active camouflage very soon here, right now. And so a minute and 15 seconds from now, the next camouflage will come up. So I'll just briefly point out here again, my overall strategy for getting a perfection is to time the camo. I don't have a timer, I'm just using the general tactics of knowing that 30 seconds after my camouflage deactivates, I know that the camo will come up, and then I go back for the camo. And while I'm in camo, I get kills with the rockets and maybe some long-range BR kills, but I go and grab more rocket ammo in those rocks using the camo. Now, one of the reasons I uploaded this gameplay is because that doesn't work out perfectly every single time in this particular gameplay, which is why I found this gameplay a little bit more interesting. Because I can see that some enemy players have spawned over here near this base, so I'm a little bit leery pushing out. Again, I don't need to jump while doing this. There's no need to do so. But you can see that I have 2 rockets in my clip, but once again, I have 0 in reserve, so when I pick up the ammo, I'm going to grab 4 extra rockets. So you can have a maximum of 2 rockets. They just have to be in your clip with 0 in reserve. I'm hitting home that point a lot. Because it's really important to get perfections. Now, the reason why I actually went over here is because I got a call out from my teammate that he's getting sniped from these rocks, so I'm able to surprise this guy, and he backs up, and I thankfully have my rockets reloaded, so I'm able to get a splash damage kill on him. Now, I need to reload my weapons, particularly my rocket launcher. That's why I'm switching weapons so much here, and that sniper only has 3 bullets in it. So I pick up the sniper rifle here. I'm able to get a kill top center on this guy who had the sword, and I call out that to Bubfield is that he drops the sword there. Then I see this ghost, and I'm going to put 2 more shots into this ghost, and that ends up being crucial to my teammate who engages in a ghost duel right here. I don't fire a rocket, and I'm able to really strongly assist him with that wingman and vehicle destroy assist. But now I don't have any more active camouflage, so I need to either make one of two decisions. Either one, I can go off to the right here and try to make the jumps up past these fusion coils to get back top center, or I can make the more safe play and go over near the base, okay? And the reason why is because we've just killed off some people here, so I'm pretty sure that even if someone is in the base right now as I'm pushing in, they're going to have pushed out by the time I enter the base. So that's why I'm going to go in from behind here, and I have the rocket launcher, so I'm pretty sure that whoever I meet in the base, I can deal with them, and I'm going to make my way safely back to active camouflage, or the active camo spawn. This is a really consistent way to get perfections. I've gotten 3 perfections, I think, maybe even more so far in this map. I would like to point out also how my teammate Bubfield could have gotten active camouflage. He called it up for me, or should I say he called it out for me, and he did not grab it so that I could continue my perfection and my spree. Shout out to him and also my teammate Yol for helping me during this video. About the time you get the Killing Frenzy or the Running Riot is when I actually start trying to go for the perfection. What you're seeing here is just my typical bot mentality when playing Stone Town, particularly Team Slayer for sure. Now right here, the only reason I'm able to do what I'm doing right now is because the fusion coils are not here, which is really important. I see a lot of people hanging out in this window, and one of the definite conclusions you can draw from when you see people hanging out in this window is that there's going to be more people who are spawning beach, generally speaking. So I'm going to get a long-range rocket off on this guy, and yes, you can jump across from here. You can crouch jump onto this little area right here. I didn't do that here. I just wanted to let you know that you can do that as I get the assist for my teammate right here. And I'm going to long-range rocket a guy in the window here for the rampage. Going to get a long-range rocket here. Do not drop your rocket launcher, and I want to really hit this point home. So for you guys who don't know, if you have the rocket launcher, it will not respawn. It's not like the other Halo games, like Halo 4, where it will come up regardless of whether you have a sniper in your possession or not. It will not respawn if you have the rockets, even if the rockets are empty and you don't have any more, as you see here. So do not drop the rocket launcher. That's probably the most consistent mistake I see people make on this map, besides not going for rocket ammunition because they don't know it's there, is dropping the rockets outright, which is a really bad play to make. If you were to drop the rockets when you have zero, the enemy player is not going to be able to pick them up. I'm just pointing that out. So you can go back and retime them, so to speak, and re-pick up the rockets, which is really useful. Now, right now, this is kind of a slower portion of the film because I know that my teammates are engaging the enemy players on the beach, okay? And I'll just briefly zoom my camera over here so you guys can figure this out. But they're going to be spawning on the beach, and you can see how multiple players are here. This player may be even AFK, I'm not even sure. But keep in mind that when you're spawning the players on the beach, once again, it's a disadvantageous spawn. It's not very advantageous, should I say, for players to spawn on the beach. So you want to keep them spawning there. Unless you're going for some crazy multi-kills, which I'm not in this gameplay. I'm just going for the perfection, strictly speaking, even though I did get that overkill earlier on in the gameplay. I'm mainly just trying to stay alive, so I'm not trying to push up, I'm not trying to, oh, I see my teammates' red X's, so they died over there, oh my gosh, I gotta rush over there. No, that's not what I'm trying to do, I'm just trying to stay alive. You can see my teammates are all pushing up on the beach. I don't necessarily like that. You can see that's why I'm hanging back here, not just only just waiting for camo, but I don't know when my teammates, who are all pushed up on the beach, I don't know what time frame I have before all of the enemy players end up spawning in this base and coming across and seeing me waiting on camo. So I gotta be really careful here. And it's really important, just that mentality that I'm having here. A lot of players would choke at this point and would think, oh, the gameplay's getting slow. I'm not doing something right. No, if you're going for a perfection, there are slow points in the game, particularly in the end portions of the film. That's happened to me in several of my videos, and all the other perfections I've had on this map, Stone Town, have been much less exciting than this one. You can see that this guy is kind of pursuing me here. I'm going to actually kind of back up and show two things that happen here. This elite right here kind of charges up, but my teammate is going to get sniped right here, and that's Bubfield, who just got sniped from Froman. Now, this elite actually ends up dropping here. And I'm going to switch back to my player perspective as I tell Yol, who's in front of me, do not go for the window, okay? Do not go for this window. I'm going to make my way to it because I have active camouflage. And this is another way, as long as you know beach spawn is secure, you can push through this area and be pretty relatively safe. And you can see how I just pause briefly, making sure this guy doesn't know I'm here. And I'm going to jump up and rocket him, making sure to jump away from the possible fusion coils that are here. And I just want to make sure that there's no fusion coils here. Eventually, I see the sniper, which ended up exploding and dropping right here down onto the ramp. Kind of unfortunate. I'm not going to expose myself until I know I can make the shot. I'm not going to try for any dirty whip scope. And I see grenades incoming, so I just really want to stay alive. Yes, I did see that player who was hanging out in that doorway, but I'm not going to go for him because there's really no need. I have the perfection right now. I have the 15 kills. You can see that little dancing body, which I'll show you in a little Easter egg at the end of the video. Hint, hint. And then I'm going to kind of maneuver my way back to the active camo tower. You can jump up here at any point on the other Halo maps. You really can't make your way around as easily along this area. I'd highly recommend knowing how to make these jumps, especially the jumps around Camo Tower that you've seen me make throughout this film. It makes your maneuverability on this map that much more lethal. So I'm going to kind of wait on the active camo here, but I hear, using my surround sound Astro headset, I hear a guy using the lift right here. And when you know someone's controlling rockets, you really don't want to be lifting up because that is what's going to happen to you. And if you hear other guys lifting up, which I do again here, I'm going to nade. Now, I do get sniped at from this beach spawn. When you hear people coming up this lift, and again earlier in the film, how I mentioned when you see people in this window, basically that was almost a guaranteed spawn for other people on the beach. And you're going to see other people make alternate pushes along the beach. So I get that nade kill on the guy lifting for the untouchable, but I don't have any more rockets and I don't have any more shields, so I'm going to let my shields regenerate as Yoel is protecting me here and is going to shotgun this guy behind me as he gets a killing spree there. Now I see that's my teammate, so I'm going to see if I can maybe snipe this guy who sniped me in the body earlier. But this film is going to wrap up to its conclusion here as not much else happens. I hope this film helps you understand how to get perfection more easily on Stone Town. For you people watching on your mobile device, on the mobile app, if you want to click on the card in the top right-hand corner, that will take you to another video where I very clearly explain how to open your rush, not from the base spawn, but from beach spawn, to grab camo the quickest way you can, and I analyze that in a rather short video. As you can see here, I got the perfection, and I'll switch over to my stats screen here. You can see my kills and deaths and the medals I got. Shout out again to Yoel and Bubfield, my teammates, during this film. And guys, thank you for watching. Let me know what you thought of this film in the comment section down below. I really do like to read comments from you guys and reply to them and have conversations with you guys if you have any questions. So I'll see you down there or in my next video. Peace. For the shotgun, I'm then going to back up a little bit behind this rock. And this is all you really need to back up. You want to be a few steps from the rock. I'm going to run forward. These few steps will allow me to gain full momentum before jumping. I'm going to crouch jump on top of this rock. And then.